Why is it that while traveling in a bus, if you're not holding any support, you tend to fall backwards when the bus starts to move, and you tend to fall forwards if the bus stops suddenly? Before I answer this, let us visit Newton's first law. Newton's first law of motion states that an object at rest continues to be at rest, and an object in motion continues to move with the same velocity unless an unbalanced force is applied to it. So one way to interpret this is that an object at rest has a tendency to be at rest, and an object in motion has a tendency to be in motion with the same velocity. And this tendency of an object to stay at rest or to keep moving with the same velocity is known as inertia. So, inertia is the tendency of an object to remain in its present state of motion and to resist any change in its present state of motion. Because of inertia, an object not only remains in its present state of motion, but it also resists any change in its present state of motion. Further, higher the resistance, higher is the inertia. Now, if we have these two cars, which one do you think would be easier to move? Since both these cars are initially at rest, they would have a tendency to be at rest. That is, they would resist a change in their state of motion. We notice that it is comparatively easy to move the small car, but it is difficult to move the bigger one. Therefore, the bigger car or the car weighing more exhibits more resistance. Hence, the heavier car has more inertia. So, we saw that higher the mass, greater would be the inertia. So, mass is a measure of inertia. Now, inertia could be of two types. Inertia of rest, which is the tendency of an object at rest to stay at rest. And inertia of motion, which is the tendency of an object in motion to keep moving with the same velocity. Now, the concept of this inertia of rest or inertia of motion may sound counterintuitive to you. But let me show you some videos to demonstrate the same. Observe this setup carefully. We notice that the chalk is kept exactly on top of the opening of the bottle. Now notice what happens if we move the ring very quickly. See, the chalk did not move along with the ring, but fell inside the bottle. Why did this happen? This happened because the chalk possessed inertia of rest. So when the ring was set in motion, the chalk resisted the change in motion because of which it fell into the bottle. Can you give me an example where we use inertia of rest of an object to do our work? Well, an example would be cleaning of our carpets. When we beat the carpet, we set the carpet in motion. But the dust particles resist the change in motion due to inertia of rest, and hence the dust particles fall off. Now observe what happens here. We notice that when the two chairs collide, the books move from one chair to the other. Why did the books move from one chair to the other? Well, the books were also moving along with the chair and hence possessed inertia of motion. So when the chair stopped or went backwards, the books continued in their line of motion due to inertia of motion and hence got transferred to the other chair. Now let us look at a real life application of this concept. What happens in a car accident? When we are sitting in a car, our body attains the velocity of the car. Now if the car suddenly stops, our body continues to be in motion due to the inertia of motion, and we could hit ourselves against the car. Hence, it is very important to wear seat belts while sitting in a car. So now, can you answer why you fall backwards when the bus starts moving or fall forwards when the bus suddenly stops? Well, when the bus is at rest, your body is also at rest. Now when the bus starts to move, your body resists the movement due to the inertia of rest, and hence you tend to fall backwards to maintain your initial position. Similarly, in a moving bus, your body is also in a state of motion. Now when the driver suddenly applies brakes, your body resists coming to rest due to inertia of motion, and hence you fall forwards. So Newton's first law of motion can be interpreted in terms of the tendency of an object to stay at rest or to keep moving with the same velocity. And hence, Newton's first law is also known as the law of inertia.